Hello again, this is Kent from simpletutorials.net, and today we're going to do sort of a remix of other people's artwork. And one of the best places you can get artwork for free and artwork that you can actually remix and use as your own is openclipart.org right here. And we are going to be doing something that I'll just call icons on the brain. Basically, you get a head or a profile of a head, and then you stick various icons inside it. I see this quite often, various places, and they can be used for presentations, brochures, business, or it could be used in education, for various, various reasons people might want to use something like this. So what we're going to do is we're going to use this head, silhouette of a brain, and then I went to the various other places inside openclipart.org and got a heart, got a question mark, and then there's a bunch of icons in here that we could use. So probably use some of the gears, maybe the palm trees or palm tree, and then we'll have clouds and lightning. And I have already dropped everything in to my drawing space. And the way you want to do that is you can get all your files together in a folder or something, and all you want to do is just drag from, for instance, let's drag this silhouette of a brain. So I'm just clicking on it and then dragging into my drawing space. And incidentally, I didn't mention, but all my other videos have Inkscape, or I'm using Inkscape. This is Inkscape, and you get that. It's free software, Inkscape.org. It actually edits vector graphics, edits them, creates them, and it's an amazing tool that I encourage everyone to use. And when you're actually using clipart from openclipart.org, they give you the graphics both in, well, there's actually three ways now. They give you it in SVG format, which is vector format. Then you can get it in PNG and also PDF. Okay, so anyway, what we want to do is we want to get from this head to this head. And the easiest way to do it is, first of all, we're going to get rid of this brain. And then we'll take this graphic. And sometimes you might have to ungroup. For instance, let's say this was in here and it was maybe grouped, and it'll be different for various graphics that you get. So this is grouped right now, and all you're going to have to do is right click and then go to ungroup, and then we can just delete this. I'm hitting the delete key on my keyboard. To get this into a head like these down here, you can do something. You can do it like a, well, I'm going to use the circle tool or ellipse tool. And then you get a, let's see, I can just set it right about right there. And then you want to click, have this, keep this clicked, and then, or selected, and then select the other one also. Then go up to path and hit difference. Okay? Now, if you look in really close, and I'm hitting number 3 on my keyboard to go really close in, you see these pointy edges here? I don't always like that. So what I'll do is I'll select each one of these heads. And then I'll go and I'll click inside here in any of this area. Let's click into the stroke area down here in the brown. And then you'll see that this pops up, the stroke paint, and then also stroke style. And what you want to do is, if you click on these right here, it will round up those pointy edges. Okay, and for the graphics that I want to create, I want these to be gray fill. So you just click down here for whatever fill you want. And then right here in the stroke, I want it to be black. So I right clicked over this area right here to get to my black stroke. But another way to do that is with all these selected, you can hold down your shift key on your keyboard and then click in one of these colors. See how that changed to red? Well, I'll go back to black. Okay, now let's go in here and stick each one of these icons, I mainly searched on icon inside openclipart.org to get some of these drawings or these graphics. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to speed up after the first one, I'll speed up the video and you'll see what happens with, you know, each of these little heads. But for this first one, what you can do to get this inside the head is to hold these their handles or their arrows on the each corner. Hold down your control key so you make it proportional, and then kind of move down to the lower left hand corner, and then you can put that in there. Now if you want to have a different color, there's some gradient in there, but I think that you can actually put a different color, a solid, or you can go back to the gradient. Yeah, just undo. Okay, so I'm gonna speed up the video and go on with the rest of these. Okay, there you have it. One thing you might have noticed when I was doing this is that each one of these graphics was behind the heads, and that's because the heads were created after I inserted the graphics. And what you want to do is to get this in front of the head, you can hit your home key. It'll bring it all the way to the top. If you hit your end key on your keyboard, it'll go all the way to the back. You can also bring it up by going page up, and it will go up in closer to you, or closer to the very top with each page up stroke, or each time you hit the page up, it'll continue to go a little higher towards the top of the drawing space. Okay, that's it. Thank you for watching. This is Kent from SimpleTutorials.net. If you like the video, go ahead and hit like, and if you want to subscribe to see more, do that, or hit the subscribe button also. Thank you for watching. Have a good day. Bye-bye.